On September the 1st, 1939, the Germans invaded Poland, which was the official beginning of World War II. Whereas in Germany, the Germans had had to control 500,000 or so Jews, many of whom had already left, in Poland, they had 3 million Jews throughout the country to figure out how to control and account for them. The reason then that they established ghettos, which were in the poorest parts of town, they could do three things. They could concentrate them all in one place, they could control them, and they could take all of the possessions from the homes that the Jews had abandoned, because they were only allowed to take what they could carry. You can see here the model of the Lodz ghetto with the bridge, which was one of the limited number of entrances or exits to the ghetto. And if you can see quickly or closely, you would see very, very cramped and crammed circumstances. It was in the poorest part of town, and interestingly, the ghetto was not the invention of the Germans. It was invented 400 years earlier by the Italians in Venice. And it was one of many things that the Germans took from history to abuse and control the Jews. Because they were crammed into apartments and some of them had to live on the streets, you can imagine that the hygiene, the water, food, sanitation was very, very compromised. The old, the young, the ill, most of them did not survive. So how did you survive? Virtually any way that you could. You can see a man bartering his goods there, a young boy who tried to steal some bread. They worked in factories. You can see leather factory here. You can see a young, very young Leo Wolf, whose name you've probably heard before in the museum, in a factory here. Interestingly, the Germans allowed the Jews to establish a governing council called the Judenrat, which really had no power. This council made the Jews available to work in the ghettos, thinking that this would allow the Jews to survive longer. Schools and synagogues were forbidden, and there could be reprisals if they were discovered. But the Jews did these in an underground way. They did establish schools, they did establish synagogues, and they did continue to have life as much as normal. Eventually, the Germans emptied out the ghettos and sent the remaining inhabitants off to either concentration, slave, or labor camps, or death camps.